So we're coming to you live from the kitchen. Making cookies.
Of parchment paper.
With cutters.
And Father
Ta-da!
Father Lawrence's, yay, Father Lawrence's sister's famous recipe for sugar cookies. Wow. What are we making these cookies for?
It's a secret.
As it should be. The church knows when to maintain secrets.
First communion is this weekend. So, yes. So, if you didn't know this, the Eucharist was the plan from the beginning. If we really want to look at Eucharistic theology, we have to understand what God really wanted. What did God want? He wanted to be with his people. That's what the Garden of Eden was. And he wanted to walk with them in fellowship and be with them. And so that was all ruined when the human race fell from its dignity. But God doesn't leave us there, such does God love us, that he sent us his only begotten Son to be our Savior. Well, at the very Last Supper, Jesus gave us the gift of the Eucharist before he went to his passion on the cross. And in that gift of the Eucharist, we see the love of God. And some people don't really believe in the real presence in the Eucharist. They find it hard to believe that God, being all-powerful, being almighty, would come to become a mere human person. Like, why would God do that? And that's a great question. Why would God do that? Well, the answer has always been because God loves us. And he wants us for himself. He wants us to acknowledge his presence in our life so that we can move forward together. Yeah, I'm not loving the parchment paper, but
I'm going to ask you to describe the fabulous runners we have going on here.
Oh, well, those are to keep the dough to the thickness I want, which is about 1/4 inch. So they're just 2 guard sticks from Lowe's that I picked up today.
Fabulous. I would never have thought of that.
So it just keeps everything at the same height. And again, got all of this from watching my sister, who actually does this professionally. But the stuff she makes is way out of this world. She can make a sugar cookie look like a watermelon. I did not have that skill. But back to the Eucharist, because God loves us so much and he wants us to be with him, he had this meal with the apostles, the Last Supper. And need more dough.
And we have more dough. So, Father, what's the relationship between manna that the people of Israel received in the desert and the body of Christ as presented at the Last Supper?
Well, so the manna in the desert was a foreshadowing of the Eucharist. God provides for his people. God provides for his people. God has always provided. He will always provide. That's the thing we have to remember. So as we remember, God provides. Well, in the desert, they had nothing to eat. And they were grumbling. They would rather be slaves in Egypt than free without their creature comforts. But Jesus, following Jesus, is a life of sacrifice. Well, why should we have to sacrifice? Well, because that's just who we are as people, right? And the Eucharist is a sacrifice. It is a giving of one's life. Like, look at us here. We're making cookies for our kids in our church. There's 100 other things each of us could be doing right now. But it's a sign of love. Right?
And Father is desperately trying to not complain again about the absence of love. Also a sacrifice. I think these things are small sacrifices. You know?
So, in that, we have these great signs of love that surround us always. Because if we just look around us in creation, especially here in Florida, we're surrounded by God's goodness. To really put you in mind of how just wonderful the world is, how it is made with all this beauty. And this is what Jesus steps into in the incarnation. He becomes one of us to live like one of us, that he can show us the proper way to live and to appreciate things. And the fact is that it all goes through the cross. So we give up our will just as Jesus gave his will to the Father. Part of that will is the Eucharist, again, because we have this celebration of the bread and the wine that we break together as God's family. And we acknowledge that not everyone who should be at the table is there. And we want them to experience God's love as we have experienced it. And we want our children to grow up with the knowledge of God's love as we have. That one broke apart.
On that note,
dun dun dun, cookie surgery time.
So here we are in phase three of the cookie making, and we are about to start the fun part. Dot, dot, dot. So if all of you could say your name and tell us something that we don't already know about you, which is pretty much 99.9%.
Should I say me?
You're first.
I am Elias Garcia Guerra.
I am Sophia Sierra Tovar Stetter.
I'm Allison Daniel Lee Romero.
Okay, so what's your favorite part about being Catholic?
That's a hard one.
Steubenville.
Nice promo.
Yeah.
Elias. Good
what
answer.
A kid.
What about you?
Just like Sophia Steubenville, like all the fun events.
Okay, because they're spiritually enlightening, embracing.
They are.
And they bring you closer to Jesus. Right. Okay, so what are we making there, Sophia?
We're making the icing for the first communion cookies.
Yeah, but okay, what do we got? What are the ingredients? What do we got?
We've got 6 cups of confectioner sugar. And we've got a quarter cup of milk.
A quarter cup of milk and confectioner sugar. That's it?
Yes.
Okay, and I would highly recommend before we begin to use our electric mixer that you mix it as much as you can with a nice spatula like this so that when you put your mixer in there and you start mixing, you don't get confectioner sugar all over the kitchen. So right now I'm going to say a small prayer that that doesn't happen. Go ahead. Hit it, Sophia.
Oh.
Allison can put her
hands like this.
So far, so good. So what are we doing now?
Adding a quarter cup of corn syrup.
Quarter cup of corn syrup. Did we add a little bit more milk to the
Yeah, you do it a little bit at a time until it gets nice and creamy. Now I need the 2 tablespoons of the almond extract.
Oh, and the cookies are ready.
What part are we on now?
Food color.
Okay, tell us what you're doing there.
Adding food color.
What colors did you guys pick?
We'll find out in a minute. You can't get it.
How much do you add, Father, of the food color?
Not as much as I just did.
Yeah, it can be very intense these days, huh?
It looks like it's black.
Ooh, that's beautiful, though.
That's
now you got to use the strength of your arm, my friend.
Okay.
The strength of your arm. I don't want to see a single white streak.
Mm. I love the colors.
Take a look at what we have over here. We have Father's fabulous sugar cookies.
Beautiful.
And we have Lily's rustic chocolate praline. Thank God they didn't burn cookies.
Mm-hmm. That's so true.
All right, gentlemen, tell me about what's going on now.
Well, we're trying to ice these, and well, you know.
These look beautiful.
The icing will be fun, but it's a little drippy right now.
These are looking beautiful. You guys picked great colors.
And we have a lot more to do.
Well, I think we had a very successful First Communion baking cookie party. And here are the results. My rather rustic, iced, but still yummy praline cookies. And then Father's spectacular and beautifully iced homemade sugar cookies. So again, we'll send you the recipes, we'll have the recipes at the bottom of this screen available for you. Take care.